Good morning, children. Let's continue with yesterday's chapter, Minerals and Energy Resources. We have studied what is a mineral and what are the important types of minerals available. Also, we studied that minerals are not uniformly distributed on the earth's surface or in the earth. There are some regions that abundantly these minerals are available, and some regions there is shortage also. There will be scarcity, and some regions there is no mineral at all. So with this, today we are going to discuss about where are these minerals found and what is the mode of occurrence of these minerals. As we know that minerals are not found exactly as in the same form which we are extracting. It is generally found in the form of ores. This is the impure form of minerals. Ores, we know that the accumulation of any mineral mixed with the other elements. Also, we studied earlier classes about the rocks. Rocks are mixed with many elements or minerals. Here, from the ores, we have to extract these minerals. So mostly we know that it also may be a costly affair, because we know that to extract the minerals from interior of the earth, it's very expensive in many cases. So that we need to use the modern technology for the extraction of these minerals. So minerals generally occur in the different forms, especially in the igneous and metamorphic rocks. Minerals may occur in the cracks, wherever there are cracks or crevices, that is also like cracks or the damages in the soil or in the lithosphere. So there are also in the faults and joints it can be found. Due to the tectonic movements, the faults and joints also occur on the earth. So these are found in the igneous and metamorphic rocks. These type of minerals are found in the crevices or the cracks or joints or faults, etc. The smaller occurrence, which means the smaller quantities, if the minerals are occur, these are called veins, and if it is large quantity, it is called lodes. So in most cases, they are formed with when minerals in liquid or molten or gases forms. They are formed or forced to move upward, like the lava flows. We know that when volcanic eruption occurs, lava flows out. So like that, these are in the form of molten and gases or liquid or coming upward or the outside the earth surface through these cavities or through these crevices or cracks. So when these are coming outside on the way, sometimes this liquid becomes solid also. The liquid or magma or these minerals are also in the different forms, I mean in the gaseous form or liquid form, it will be solidified. So they slowly cool and solidify, and when they are rising up, that means which they are coming outside their surface. So major metallic minerals like tin, copper, zinc and lead are obtained from these veins and lodes. In other ways, we can find in the sedimentary rocks this type of minerals. There are number of minerals occur in beds and layers, level flat layers or beds it can be. So they have been formed as a result of the deposition, accumulation and concentration of horizontal data. When these sediments are deposited on the river beds or river banks, these can be found there. So minerals are also occurring from these sediments. Coal and other forms of iron ore have been concentrated as a result of long periods under great heat and pressure. So these minerals, coal and iron ore, also can be available or found in this concentration of beds and layers. So another group of sedimentary minerals include gypsum, potash salt and sodium salt. These are formed as a part of the evaporation, especially in the arid regions or dry regions in the where the evaporation is high. Other mode of formation or occurrence of minerals involving the decomposition of the surface rocks and the removal of soluble constituents, also leaving a residual mass of weathered material containing ores. Bauxite is formed in such a way. That means from the weathered rocks continuously when these are exposed to the sunlight or different climatic conditions, maybe winter or summer or different climatic conditions, the weathered rocks are weathered which are on the surface of the earth. So these are the different ways, and from there we can find the residual mass of weathered rocks. Such kind of minerals are found. This is bauxite is one of the examples, we can say, in such a way the minerals are formed. Now another way the certain minerals occur as alluvial deposits in sands of valleys or floors of the base of hills. We know that alluvial, where the alluvial deposits occur due to the soil erosion and also the flow of rivers. When the alluvium which is brought by the rivers from the hilly or mountainous regions are deposited on the banks of rivers when the flow of water becomes slower. So in this, so these deposits are called placer deposits and generally contain minerals which are not corroded by water, which are not wearing away by water or corroded by water. So we can find such kind of plenty of minerals, especially gold, silver, tin, platinum. This type of valuable minerals are found in alluvial deposits also. These are important minerals we can especially found for making, especially used for making jewelries. Also another way of occurrence of minerals are the ocean water also contains large quantities of minerals. But the most of these are too widely diffused to be economic significance. But we know that common salt and magnesium and bromide, these are largely derived from the ocean floors or ocean water. Oceanic beds are also too are rich in manganese nodules also. But we know that exploring these are very expensive also when it is in the ocean water. Now we know different types of mining and occurring in different parts of the world. We can say in our country rat hole mining. How do you know that these type of minerals in India are nationalized? It is not the private property. Minerals are the asset of the government of India. It is nationalized so that the extraction of these minerals are not possible by the common men. We have to get the permission from the government. If private individuals or private companies also get the permission from the government or take a license. So most of the tribal regions in India, they do not follow the rules and regulations of the government. There are also some of the tribals and individual communities in the tribal areas or the hilly regions in the northeastern states. Especially in Meghalaya region, there are large deposits of coal, iron ore, etc., limestone and dolomite, etc. But coal mining in the Jowai and Chirapunji is done by family member in the form of long narrow tunnel, and which is called rag hole mining. So these regions, people from the families or the communities, they extract the minerals themselves. In the hilly regions, they make tunnels and individually they go inside the tunnel and remove or pick up the minerals, especially coal, for their domestic purposes. The National Green Tribunal has declared such kind of activities are illegal, not on legal. It is illegal and recommended the government that such activities should be stopped. Otherwise, when continuously people are extracting minerals in rat hole mining, the ecological balance will be destroyed, the hilly regions will be destroyed. So that it is, they recommended, the National Green Tribunal has recommended or suggested the government that to stop this type of activities. India also is, we know that, very fortunate, lucky to have fairly rich and varied mineral resources. There are plenty of resources available in our country. These are, however, unevenly distributed, not concentrated in any particular areas. It is distributed all over our country. So such kind of, we can say in the peninsular India, South India, in the peninsular regions, there are also most of the reserves of this type of minerals, like coal, metallic minerals, mica, and many other non-metallic minerals, these are available. In sedimentary rocks on the western and eastern flanks of the peninsula, west and eastern regions of the peninsula, also in Gujarat and Assam have most of the petroleum deposits. Rajasthan reserves, Rajasthan region, we know that the rock systems of the peninsula and also has a reserves of many non-ferrous minerals. And the vast alluvial plains of North India, where the rivers of Ganga and Yamuna are flowing through. These regions also, there are some of the minerals available. And these variations exist largely because of the difference in the geological structure of our country, or processes and time involved in the formation of minerals. We know that we have studied some of the minerals are exhaustible minerals. It takes many thousands of years to regenerate also. So such kind of minerals are very less available. We know, for example, petroleum is available in the Gulf countries and very less, or there is scarcely available in our country also. Now the concentration of these minerals are found, we already studied that, in the form of ores also. The ease of extraction and closeness to the market play an important role in affecting the economic viability of the reserve, wherever it is available, and how much cost it takes for the extraction of minerals. Depending upon this, and market facilities, transportation facilities, these are all the factors where these minerals are, how these minerals are extracted. So, to meet the demand, a choice has been made between the number of possible options. When this is done, the mineral deposit or a reserve take into a mine. When in Chandrapur district, we can find there are coal mines, because coal is available here, and government also take initiative to mine the coal. And here there are markets and transportation facilities and all available, so that it is easy to mine the mineral or extract the mineral from the earth. So there will be a coal mine, or the reserves, wherever there are reserves or the stock of minerals, it becomes a mine. So tomorrow we are going to study about different types of minerals, ferrous minerals, or we have studied that the classification metallic, non-metallic and energy minerals. So we will study more about these classifications in the next class. That's all for today. Thank you.